हेलो, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू महबूबाद एजुकेशन यूट्यूब चैनल। माई सेल्फ सोमलिंगम उपुला, स्कूल असिस्टेंट बायोलॉजिकल साइंस फ्रॉम ZPHS पेनगोंडा मंडल के समुद्रम। ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस one more important topic from the lesson excretia, which is excretia in plants. So today our topic is excretia in plants, and as we know, in all the organisms, due to various metabolisms, always some wastages are formed. Of course, in plants also some wastages are formed. So plant, it wants to prepare different type of substances for growth and development, so that the substances which are prepared by the plants, some are waste substances. Means finally plants also, they are producing some type of different types of wastages. But plant doesn't have a specific organ for excretia. They don't have the kidneys like organs. They don't have any type of a particular system for excretia. Though the plant doesn't have any special system for excretia, it has the power to manage the wastages. Repeat. Though the plant, they don't have any specific organs and system for excretia, they have the ability to manage them. They have the power to use in different activities, of course. In the respiration, carbon dioxide and water vapor are waste substances. So in the respiration, carbon dioxide, water vapors are wastages. In the photosynthesis, oxygen is the waste material, and of course plant has the power to utilize this wastage also for other activity. For example, the wastage from the respiration, carbon dioxide and water vapor are very important for the plant in photosynthesis. And as well as the waste material of the photosynthesis, which is oxygen, which is so important for respiration. Anyway, the wastages of carbon dioxide, water vapor from respiration, oxygen from the photosynthesis, these are expelled out by the plant through small pores on the leaves as well as on stem. The wastages like carbon dioxide, water vapor, oxygen expelled, sent outside through the small pores on the leaves are known as stomata. And again, small openings on the stem are known as lenticels. So through the stomata and the lenticels, a plant has the ability to excrete the wastages like carbon dioxide, water vapor, and as well as oxygen. And again, the accumulation of wastages in the plants are very slow rate comparatively animals. The breakdown of wastages as well as accumulation of wastages are very low in rate in plants. Means they synthesize, they produce the wastages very low in rate. And again, these wastages are preserved and stored by different parts of the plant. For example, roots, bark of the stem, leaves, flowers, even fruits. So different type of wastages in the plants are stored temporarily in various parts of the plants, like mostly leaves, flowers, fruits, and as well as bark. When the huge amount of wastages are accumulated in the leaves, fruits and bark, now the plant itself, it wants to shedding down the leaves, shedding down the fruits and peeling the bark, and automatically by shedding down all these parts, now plant has the power to manage the wastages without having any complication. Listen to me. mostly in the plants. Different type of wastages are stored in different parts like leaves, bark of the stem, as well as in fruits. When the huge amount of wastages are stored in the leaves, fruits and bark, periodically these are fall off. Periodically, by shedding down of leaves, bark and fruits, plant has the power to manage the wastages without having any problem. Means successfully plant can manage the wastages. And of course, when the plant has more amount of water which is excreted through the transpiration as well as gutation. So the plant has more amount of water, it will be excreted through the transpiration as well as gutation. Of course, we know the meaning of transpiration. When the weather is so hot, plant wants to eliminate the water in the form of water vapor through the stomata is known as a transpiration. Huge amount of water, it will be excreted by the plant in the form of water vapor through the stomata is known as transpiration. And of course, in the night time, when the weather is so cool, the plant has more amount of water. It wants to excrete in the form of gutation by having the small droplets of the water from edges of the leaves. So in the night time, in the cool atmosphere, the plant has excess amount of water, it will be excreted through the droplets of water from the edges of the leaves is known as gutation. Means through the transpiration and gutation, plant has the power to manage the excess amount of water. Different type of chemical wastages are stored in the plants of different parts. As we know already, these chemicals are not so tasty for predators and sometimes so poisonous also. So different type of some chemicals are stored in various parts of the plant. They are not so tasty, sometimes they are so poisonous. That is why. By storage of different type of chemicals in various plants of the body, it has a defense mechanism. Itself, it has the power to save the body from the predatory animals. Means by storage of different type of wastages in various parts of the plant, which can maintain a defense mechanism, which has the power to save the body itself from the predatory animals. So in that way, sometimes wastages are very useful for the plant in a defense mechanism. And of course, generally plants produce mostly two type of substances. They are classified into two categories. They are primary metabolites and the second one is secondary metabolites. For example, proteins, carbohydrates, lipids are known as primary metabolites. Carbohydrates, proteins are lipids. And lipids are known as primary metabolites, which are so important for the growth and development of the plant. And the second category, the second variety of, they are known as secondary metabolites. They are not important for the growth and development of the plant. Those are known as secondary metabolites, the substances which are not play important role in the growth and development of the plant are known as secondary metabolites. For example, alkaloids, tannins, resins, latex and gums. Listen to me. Some substances which are no role to play in the growth and development of the plant are known as secondary metabolites. They are alkaloids, tannins, resins, gums and latex. So we discuss now one by one. Now alkaloids. So alkaloids are the nitrogenous byproducts. Alkaloids are the nitrogenous waste compounds stored in various parts of the plant which are so poisonous. In general, alkaloids are the nitrogenous waste compounds, nitrogenous byproducts, which are so poisonous. They are present in various parts of the plant. Due to their economical importance, we are using them in different sectors. Whatever the wastages, of course, it might be alkaloids, tannins, resins, latex, and gums. Though they are the wastages of the plants, so we are using them in various sectors due to their economic importance. So, firstly, alkaloids. Alkaloids are the, of course, nitrogen's waste compounds, so poisonous, storage, which are storing in different parts of the plant. And of course, different alkaloids are used mostly in Ayurveda. So different type of alkaloids are used as a medicine for different type of diseases. For example, in our syllabus, we have some important alkaloids. Okay, we must know the alkaloid name, the scientific name of the plant, and as well as the usage of that alkaloid. Okay, now we discuss one by one. So number one, quinine. Quinine is a type of alkaloid which is given by a plant Cinchona officinalis. Quinine is alkaloid we get from the bark of the plant Cinchona officinalis. Quinine is a medicine for malaria fever. I repeat, quinine, a type of alkaloid. We collect this one from the bark of the Cinchona plant, Cinchona officinalis. This alkaloid is used as a medicine for malaria fever. Now, the second alkaloid is nicotine. Nicotine is one more type of alkaloid we get from the leaves of the tobacco plant. Nicotiana tobacum, the scientific name for the tobacco plant. So nicotine is one more alkaloid we get from the leaves of the tobacco plant, means Nicotiana tobacum, which is used as a insecticide. The second important alkaloid in our syllabus is nicotine, which is given by the leaves of tobacco plant, means Nicotiana tobacum. We use this one as a insecticide. The next alkaloid is morphine. Morphine is one more alkaloid is given by the fruits of the Papaveraceae somniferum, a type of plant. Morphine is alkaloid we get from the fruit of Papaveraceae somniferum. Now the morphine is used as a sedative and as well as painkiller. So morphine is an alkaloid which is very important in as a medicine for sedative as well as which is used as a painkiller. The alkaloid name is morphine, which is given by the plant name is Papaveraceae somniferum. Okay. The next alkaloid is reserpine. Reserpine is a alkaloid we get from the root of the plant Rauwolfia serpentina. Reserpine is an alkaloid we get from the root of the Rauwolfia serpentina. Now this alkaloid is very important for the snake bite. So reserpine is a medicine we are using for a snake bite, which is given by Rauwolfia serpentina. We get it from the root of the plant. It is used as a medicine for snake bite. The next alkaloid is caffeine. Generally, we are using the caffeine in a daily life. Caffeine is alkaloid we get from the seeds of the coffee plant. Caffeine is alkaloid is given by seeds of the coffee plant. The scientific name for the coffee plant is Coffea arabica. So caffeine is alkaloid given by Coffea arabica, aka coffee plant. Now this alkaloid is very important to stimulate the central nervous system. our brain and spinal cord. Nervous system is stimulated by consuming the alkaloid caffeine, which is given by a coffee plant. The scientific name for a coffee plant is Coffea arabica. So caffeine is alkaloid which has the power to stimulate the central nervous system. The next alkaloid is nimbin. Of course, we are using daily, which is so familiar to us. The one more important alkaloid is nimbin, which get from leaves, bark, as well as the seeds, fruits of the plant, neem plant, Azadi recta indica. Nimbin is an important alkaloid which is given by neem plant, Azadi recta indica. The leaves, fruits and bark of the neem plant give an alkaloid known as nimbin, which is so important. We are using as a antiseptic. So one more important alkaloid we are using in daily life, that is nimbin. Nimbin is alkaloids given by neem plant, Azadi recta indica. The neem plants, leaves, fruits and bark, they have the power to give an alkaloid known as nimbin, which is so important for antiseptic. And one more important alkaloid is scopolamine. Scopolamine is a alkaloid given by Datura plant, Datura stramonium. So scopolamine, a alkaloid we get from the fruits of the Datura plant, Datura stramonium, which is again important for sedative. We are using this alkaloid as a sedative. So scopolamine given by fruits of the Datura plant, Datura stramonium, we are using this one as a sedative. And the last one in our syllabus, the alkaloid is pyrethroids. Pyrethroid, a type of alkaloid, is given by the flower of the chrysanthemum, a plant. From the chrysanthemum plant, we are getting an alkaloid known as pyrethroids, which is so important as insecticide. So pyrethroids, a type of alkaloid, is given by chrysanthemum flower. We are using this one as insecticide. So these are all important alkaloids. Actually, all these are wastes of different plants, but due to their economic importance, we are using them as medicine in various type of diseases. For example, quinine, nicotine, morphine, reserpine, caffeine, nicotine, scopolamine, and finally pyrethroids. This information about alkaloids. The second type of vestiges of the plant is known as tannins. Tannins are the carbon compounds. Tannins are the carbon wastage materials which are stored in different parts of the plant. Mostly they are deep brown in color. So tannins, mostly we are using these in a leather industry to clean the skin of the animals. In the leather industry, we are using important wastages by the plants is known as tannin. So actually tannin is a carbon compound. Tannin is a wastage of some plants. We are using the tannins in a leather industry to clean the skin of the animals. And of course, some amount of the tannins we are using as a medicine also. For example, cassia and acacia. So cassia and acacia, these plants are giving a type of waste material known as a tannins. We are using important substance for in the leather industry. Okay. One more important wastage is resins. So the production of resins is the primary character of gymnosperms. The production of resins is a primary character of the gymnosperms. Now resins are stored mostly in the resin vessels. We are using this one in a varnish industry. in making the varnishes, we are using the resins, which are a type of waste materials, a type of wastages, which are given by mostly gymnosperms, for example, pinus. Okay, one more type of wastages, which is gum. So in general, when you cut a plant like neem or acacia, we can see from the cut some liquid is secreted, is nothing but gum. Some plants, when you cut off the stems, they want to secrete some juices which are known as the gums, actually, which are produced by the plant to healing out the wounds. By secreting some amount of gum, so plant wants to heal out the wound. But due to their economic importance, we are using the gums on different type of sectors, mostly as a agent in the binding industry. So gums, we are using mostly in the binding industry. So when you want to bind the different type of whatever the papers or books, in the binding industry, we are using gums as an important agent, which is actually a secretion secreted by some plants when they have some injuries. Actually, those plants secrete this type of gums to heal the wounds. But due to their importance, we are using them as an agent in the, especially, binding industry. For example, neem plant and as well as acacia. And the last one is latex. Latex is the milky whitish product given by some plants. Latex is a waste material produced by some plants, which is so white and milkish, of course, which is milkish white substance given by some plants. And of course, we are using different type of latex in various sectors. So for example, Hevea brasiliensis, a plant latex, we are using as a rubber. In the rubber industry, we are using a latex given by rubber plant. The scientific name for rubber plant is Hevea brasiliensis. And again, nowadays, throughout the world, to avoid the consumption of fossil fuels, to save the environment, now we are depending only on biofuels. So in the making of biofuels, biodiesel, now we are getting again a latex of the plant known as Jatropha carcass. So one more important latex of the Jatropha plant, we are using the latex of the Jatropha carcass as a raw material for preparation of biodiesel. So by consuming the biodiesel, now we can avoid the consumption of fossil fuels as well as we can save the nature from different type of pollutions. That is why one more important wastage like latex, for example, Jatropha is a plant which can give a latex. We are using this one as a raw material for biodiesel. So these are the different type of wastages. For example, alkaloids, tannins, resins, gums, latex, actually all these are wastages by different plants and they are storing in various parts of the plant. But due to their economic importance, we are using the wastage plants in different sectors. Anyway, mostly, though the plant doesn't have any specific organ for excretia, it has the power to manage the wastages successfully. Okay, here is the lesson, excretia in plants. Right, thank you.